Không cần hỏi không?
Có, nó bảo tí nói chuyện mà.
Tí nói đúng không?
Ờ.
Good morning from the Holyman, day 3. How are you feeling?
Sweaty.
We're currently on our way to a waterfall as the first stop of the day. Oh, there's people washing their clothes. Oh.
Okay, I think this part of this series of vlogs is the right place to address the elephant in the room, which is the amount of privileged majority white teenagers and 20 something year olds making a playground out of somewhere that is home to so many traditional Vietnamese families. This is a contrast that I noticed quite a bit as we were travelling through the Ha Giang Loop, and this morning in particular it is quite a stark contrast. Obviously I saw a family washing their clothes in the river, and then you turn the corner and there is an abundance of travellers having fun, having a laugh, making a lot of noise in somewhere that is obviously the back garden, the home of so many Vietnamese families. And this is something that's quite difficult to navigate, and I'm not really sure how best to explain the feeling that I felt at this moment. I suppose it's just important to be aware of the surroundings that you're in. And obviously I wouldn't have had the chance to see these parts of Vietnam had I not gone on the Ha Giang Loop. I feel like there's just an element of awareness that has to come alongside this type of travelling. And I hope I've put that across well in this part of the vlog. And I guess with that being said, it's time to go back to showing you the fun side of things. I hope you enjoy the rest of the video.
Wow, okay. Oh my God, there's so many people.
I think we must have stood here for about 15 minutes cheering everybody else on before we then had a go. And although I don't have a video, I promise we did have a go.
It's the sign that says do not jump just where they're jumping for me.
Big boy.
Beautiful scenery this morning. Beep, beep. It's amazing how much entertainment you can get from a horn, isn't it? Fuck. So we've had the first fall of the trip.
High five. Happy you're okay.
It was the most pathetic. Oh, it was so slow. It was just a slow motion.
And you were smiling the whole time.
Can you smile where I've been sat? Feeling hot, hot, hot. Another incredible stop. I don't know, we seem to have lost the other half of the group. We'll see them coming from down here somewhere. The scale, man. The scale. Right. I think, is this them? No.
So I'm lost. Half the group behind us, there was an accident. I don't know what happened. But Aiden and Jasmine were there, and then I saw the other group going off ahead, so I tried to catch up with them, was almost caught up with them, and now there was a fork in the road and I don't know which way they went.
I think this life kind of suits me though. I can live here. There's a village and a shop, but yeah, I'm lost, so just gonna wait here until the group behind sort out what's happening with the accident. Hopefully they come past. Hopefully the group in front realise that they've gone ahead, and maybe they come back. But otherwise, I've got water. There's some friendly locals around here, I'm sure. Just waiting in the shade.
I'm all alone.
Oh, And then every time my motorbike comes past, I'm like, is it my friend's? It's not.
Yay!
If this isn't the most adorable thing, hello. Oh, are you tired? It's very warm. Are you sleepy? Oh,
it's a hat.
He's so fluffy. Hi. Do you want to say hello? Hi. Look at this wee thing. Is this goodbye?
This is goodbye.
We're going our separate ways. It's goodbye time. Oh, the team's off. No.
Lovely to see you. Lovely to see you again.
Yes, I know.
Can we get our next salt?
Goodbye. A long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. Bye! See you later! Safe travels!
Oh, great, now I'm stuck with you.
Oh, fuck! We've had an absolute disaster. A sun cream really. Oh, mate.
Right, it's going to get this.
Hazel. Piet pal. Look at the wall.
Almost there. There we go.
From this point on, we were only a group of six. And although we did miss the others, it meant that we could have a more authentic experience of Northern Vietnam. We were able to slow down a little, we were able to interact more with locals, and our first stop of the afternoon was to this workshop where local women spun yarn and made products out of hemp and corn materials. It was absolutely fascinating to watch the women at work, and then they also had this little shop where we could see some of the products.
Go on, give us a fashion show then. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Ooh.
Ooh.
Ooh. Ooh. You're endangering their lives, Hazel. We've picked up some friends. So these gals are showing us the local swimming spots.
We ride.
Okay. Skirt, skirt. Hazel's got a new job as a Grab driver. Hello! How cool is this?
Hello!
They've literally just brought us on their play date. Hello!
Everyone enjoy!
Yeah! So it turns out this river actually has a very strong current. This is so much fun. We've literally been here for like half an hour just playing with these kids, doing belly flop competitions. It's insane! Boys are over here skimming.
And of course, this is where the camera battery runs out of charge. After we'd done enough swimming, we then ended up staying for a little longer and playing some games on the banks of the river. It was just the most wholesome afternoon. And afterwards, we got on our bikes, started driving again for another few kilometres to our home stay for the evening.
In the red corner.
Oh, the Beatles. The Beatles interested.
Oh, the Beatles.
We have the Beatles. In the blue corner.
The Beatles.
Jamie.
He's so unbothered.
I feel like a woman. Happy water.
Happy water.
Are you guys ready?
Happy water.
Oh, we throwing it fucking down.
Vietnam. Beer.
Oh. Wait, I thought that was my beer. I'm so sorry. No, no, I'm so sorry. Any full beer is my beer.
Hi, Bob. Go, go, go.
Hi, Bob.
Hi, Bob.
One more.
Yeah.
Again.